Hello, everyone, and welcome to another edition of me yelling at things and yelling about things related to Yomi. Today, we've got a very exciting match coming up. We've got the International Yomi League finals for Season 2, Enomus versus Leontes, the Assassin versus the Dragon. With me on the microphone, very special guest. Please give a warm welcome and shout out to Bomber678.
Hey, guys.
Joining us all the way from
Australia.
Sweet.
The south.
the south of Australia, a very specific region.
I'm the southest.
The most south.
Yeah, when it comes to south.
Yes, so an expert in all things the southern. So we have two people that play characters widely considered to be, even by the people who play them, bottom tier in the finals of a, I think it was something, it was just short of 48 people, right? I think it was something like 44 or 46 or so. Several weeks of Swiss tournament in four divisions, then playoffs.
Several months.
Yeah, that's true. Crazy huge event, and Enomus playing primarily Vendetta with some... He has played some matches and has experience with Argagarg and Lum. And Leontes playing almost 100% of his games as Midori, with some Jaina, Trock, and Midalker thrown in for flavor, it seems like.
Well, Midalker to beat Southpaw here and sell his soul.
Yes. Okay, so primarily a Geiger counterpick?
Yeah.
Okay. That makes a lot of sense.
That's why I picked him.
I probably should think about that, actually.
Well, some people are saying Minoka's not that good, but I don't know.
I think in that matchup, it's widely considered pretty good. So I think this problem... So what this is looking like it's going to shape up to, based on the characters that they play, I think there's almost no reason for Leontes to pick anyone except Midori.
Yes.
Midori has... based on historical matchup chart that I maintain, has basically a 6-4 record against all three characters that Enomus has played. So 6-4 versus Vendetta, 6-4 matchup versus Lum, and a 6-4 matchup versus Argagarg. Interestingly, Enomus is actually, or Leontes has not that great of a record versus Argagarg with Midori. I'm not sure if that's that might be a personal hang-up. It could be that it's just a matter of he's happened to lose a couple more games recently when I've started recording them, and he has, you know, a perfectly typical 75% win ratio, which is basically his average with every single character, which is ridiculous.
Leontes.
Yeah, exactly. Jazz hand. We're both jazz handsing as hard as we possibly can right now.
Hear it.
Yeah.
There.
And Enomus also, I mean, with Vendetta having a 64% win rate, which is absolutely incredible. Nothing to sneeze at, especially with that character.
This character's low tier.
Yeah, as he is very fond of saying. But yeah, it doesn't stop him from absolutely bodying people in spite of that fact.
Very true. His final record being something like 8-3 in his division, playing mostly Vendetta.
Yeah, ludicrous. Ludicrous. So, looks like we are waiting for a little bit. Room's filling up. We've got about 10 people watching. Very nice.
Hype.
Yeah, exactly. Infinity air horns.
Are you going to bring the air horns?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm totally going to bring the air horns. I might.
If you would.
The only reason I won't be air horning is because you'll actually hear my hands clap against the side of my head trying to contain the excitement.
I'm okay with this. You wouldn't want to hear my hands, but I kind of have too much hair.
Yeah. It's like, I am all right with this development.
The one issue with the Steam version that CKR pointed out is that, I mean, along with the chat being not the greatest, is that you can't actually get a player list, which is kind of strange.
Huh? Oh, like, you can't tell? Like, you can tell who's online?
Yeah, you can't do that.
Interesting.
Do you have the Steam version yet?
No, I haven't gotten it. I just used the browser version, and it's got all the features I want, so.
Oh, fair enough, fair enough. I got the Steam version just because I wanted that glorious 1080p. Oh,
Oomph, etc.
Yes. Also, it loads much faster than the browser version for me, just because my internet's Australian internet.
Fair enough. Working with Canadian internet, so I feel your hashtag colonies internet. What? What the hell is going on? Oh my god.
Is this real?
Is this real life?
Is this even real?
What? Okay, prepare for the shittiest commentary ever because I have literally never seen this before. Okay, so BBB versus BBB. I guess they can both keep each other from going to range real easy.
No, because if any of their range moves hit, they go to range. And then they stay in range until someone gets hit by a non-range move, which is...
Nothing? Joker. They can Joker out, that's right.
If they both block.
That's right. So if one of them Jokers the other... Or I can't even believe this is happening. So what's the reasoning here? I can see Enomus picking BBB because BBB is a good counter pick to Midori, and none of his other characters have an advantage matchup. But why is Leontes playing BBB? Is BBB advantaged against... I guess he's good with versus Lum, he's good versus Arg, but... versus Vendetta? Yeah, this is button check. No, this is real. Like, this is happening, I'm pretty sure, isn't it?
This is really happening. I actually can't comprehend right now.
Yeah, my brain, I cannot even. I've lost the ability to can. Okay, all right, we're gonna try. We're gonna try to make this.
Wait, he just overdrived and then blocked. Air horns.
Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm leaving that in because good lord.
What? How did they go back to the main menu? How do you do that?
I don't know. Okay, best way to cut the tension ever. That's amazing.
I think we're all ready to go. Okay.
I can't wait for these people to watch this video.
Okay, yeah, so Leontes was just breaking tension. Right. So now they've warmed up their fingers.
Yes. Making sure that all their buttons work.
Yeah. Checking the controls. I think Enomus probably uses some of those janky, like, you know, he doesn't use default control setup because he's just like that. Yeah, he's a Vendetta player.
You know what he's doing is he plays Yomi on an iPad, but he plugs like a six-axis controller, like an Xbox 360. Yeah.
Infinity Gauntlet.
Yeah.
Wait, what if Enomus is secretly the guy who uses the Infinity Gauntlet?
Ooh.
What if it's really him?
We can't spoil Avengers Age of Ultron's secret scene at the end of the credits, okay? I'm gonna have to cut this whole part out. This is ridiculous.
I haven't seen Age of Ultron yet. I need to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna see it on Monday. Okay, I'm so glad. Part of me is really happy that wasn't real, and part of me is kind of disappointed that wasn't that real. Well played. Huge shoutouts to Leontes and Enomus for being huge, amazing trolls. That was phenomenal.
Did you just catch CK out trying to pull off some shady betting?
25.
Did you catch that?
Yeah, they can split the character pack, which is the prize for next season. Okay, that's your first cough count. If we get to three, I'm cutting the Skype call out.
Wow.
just like, everyone say goodbye to Bomber. I've got a giant, like, one of those huge breaker switches just at the ready on my right-hand side. Party off.
Oh, Leontes is listening to Quartered. Sick.
Okay.
Leontes has some favors on him in the betting on challenge, actually. It's, I think, about roughly 60-40.
Yeah,
Leontes' favorite. So.
Just like all of the matchup results, basically.
I mean, you know, it makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, to be fair, Enomus is a beast, but Leontes is just... maybe it's because he's a grappler and that, you know, and therefore one of my chosen people. But, like, that's ridiculous. And he does shit like throw, like, 9-throw with Midori. You don't do that! You can't do that as a human being. You're not allowed to do that.
You dying Charles Rook?
Sorry. No, with Midori. Oh, yeah, no, that's true.
Did you
yeah, but I don't have a dodge on my 9. What is that even?
It's just like throwing with your 3 as Rook.
No, no. That is not... That's not even remotely comparable.
It is. No. Dodge, special block, same thing, right?
Goodbye, everyone. That was Bomber.
Can you tell that I'm not a Rook player?
You know nothing, Jon Snow.
Yes, I would die in the Game of Thrones.
And the Game of Throws, apparently. 9 throws.
I play truck. I don't need to think.
Yeah, that's true. Fact. Hashtag Yomi fact. So, do you think we're actually going to see their mains? Are we going to see Midori versus Jen?
I honestly think we will see Midori.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not we see Vendetta, I think it's a little bit up in the air.
Well, what do you think... If not Vendetta, then who does Enomus pick?
I think Lum would be still like a fine match. I honestly think Lum Midori is probably not 6-4. I mean, admittedly, I don't play either of those characters, but just from thinking about it, like, it seems like Lum seems to have pretty good matchups against the grapplers.
Hmm. Yeah, I don't know. I can only speak to the fact that it's quite a tough matchup as Rook. But that's because there's no dodges. With Midori, yeah. I could expect... The only issue with... I guess there's a couple of different things that are, like, at work in that matchup. Midori's Dragon Q is 6 speed?
0.6, yeah.
Yeah, it's 6 speed. Yeah, 0.6 speed. And Lum's Q is 0.4.
Yeah, you're right.
So there's that. That's a... Usually... I mean, obviously there are very few matchups where the Dragon Q is uncontested as fastest attack.
Yeah.
But it's a huge boon when it is. Yes. Otherwise, I mean, the fact that Lum likes to spam face attacks because he can recur them is fine for Midori. Midori is perfectly happy to block and build a huge hand. That's very, very good for him. So, yeah, I don't know. I guess I could see that. I could see that. But then there's a matter of, you know, do you go with the character that you know the most? I won't say that you're the most confident in, because apparently... Oh, there you go. You're right. Points to Bomber.
It's my Yomi.
Yes. Yomi champion character select prediction.
In the double blind tournament I should have ended, I would have won 100% of the time.
Oh!
Ooh.
Bow, 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 bow. All right, Midori, Leontes starting off strong, undercutting a 6-throw. Very nice. And that's the thing. So Lum can be competitive with some of Midori's throws with that 6, but he's never going to get much damage off of it.
No. Sorry, Midori's slowest usual throw is his 5-throw.
Oh, that's true.
Unless... Leontes starts 9-throwing again.
Yes, and he will. Like, guaranteed, it's going to happen. Okay. You're going to see it.
Well, in that case, then Panda's 9-throw can contest Leontes' 9-throw.
That's true. Yeah, because Midori is not actually a grappler and has 0.8 throw speeds.
Midori, probably not a real grappler.
Probably not. We'll check the tapes.
Yeah.
All right, so Leontes builds back up to an 8-card hand. Lum also sitting at 8. Both of these characters very card greedy, definitely want to build to stuff. Leontes playing very aggressive to start off with.
Certainly.
Lots
playing
of
throws. Out his dragon stuff, like, straight up, so... Mm-hmm.
Typically,
he
I think...
He must be holding a couple of tens.
Sorry?
He must be holding a couple of tens.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Seems that Enomus has caught on to the, throw one turn, attack one turn, throw one turn, attack one turn, pattern that Leontes has been playing. This could be, I mean, with a best of seven, you can, I mean, spend a game just gathering data.
Yeah, he did that to me in the FFFF, and it worked. He nearly beat me.
Like, yeah.
I frauded it out.
Maximum fraud.
Not gonna lie, that was a very fraudulent match.
It was tight. It was awesome. It's really good to watch.
It was a lot of fun.
God, look at that hand size. Like, both of these characters, obviously...
They're getting ready.
all tons of fuel in the tank. Okay, Leontes losing one of those precious...
Bad move.
Yeah, exactly. He would have won there. and he goes down one of those precious dodges. So we know we suspect he's holding at least 110, so he's got at least another dodge in hand. Okay, getting thrown. Doesn't matter too much. Enomus can afford to pump that. He doesn't. But even if he did, it would be, what, 15 damage?
Yeah, that's max pump.
Yeah.
Which is not terrible damage.
Jackpot, interesting.
Yeah.
Okay, just fishing for additional hand information, I guess.
Probably.
I can't imagine that he really suspects that Leontes has, like, three aces, which is what you would probably want in a 10-card hand to be able to hit jackpot.
Yes.
Oh, it was a setup.
Oh.
Nice.
Wow,
sexy. Off of sevens.
Goodness.
That's hot. That's super hot.
The seven as well. Yeah, he blocked with the seven. Oh, that's smart.
Yeah. Sick.
Oh, no, it was a five block. Oh. Okay, weird. Oh, I suppose it still would have been on top. Silly me. Top two.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It goes down two. Yeah, that's a sick bit of tech
really,
there.
Really good play. Like,
oh, there you go. There's that interaction. So Leontes cannot flip his queen around. It's just that's beaten outright. Ooh, that's okay. That's very nice. That actually
nice.
Gets
Three
rid of.
Queen's gone.
Yeah, that's super important. So now, because Midori can recur cards if he's in dragon mode and blocks. He has the potential to have rather a lot more queens, which will do a lot more work. See, this is...
Whoa!
This is... What is this?
is he aware that can still be outsped by sixth throw? Like,
I think he just doesn't give a shit.
No? Okay.
I think he's a crazy person, and he'll just do whatever he wants.
Plays Midori.
Exactly. Okay. Not willing to... Possible that he didn't even have a higher payoff card in hand, but not bad just to get a knockdown. Midori doesn't get huge payoff off knockdowns because his cross-up normals are so slow that they can be undercut by literally anything that Lum plays, basically. But this is shaping up to be pretty even so far. Only an 8-point life difference between the two of them. Both of them huge hands. Nice. Ooh, there you go. There's the flip. Beautiful undercut with that queen. And that. So that's three queens now also spent by Leontes. Does play the J into it. No pump. God, that's damage. So jealous of that. That J pump is just ridiculous.
When you can throw for 24.
Yeah, that's the life. That's the life you want.
As a rook player.
Yes, exactly. Hey, I can throw for 50.
You can throw for 52. We're going to talk about aces.
Quiet you. Okay, going into dragon mode. Finally playing.
Oh, Final Dragon Buster!
Jeez! Yeah, you strange just go nuts on this people. One. And that's game one! That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. That's like, a hype finish.
Yeah, Final Dragon. Whatever. That's it. We're going home. Bye.
All right. And enomus sticking in the matchup. I think you're right. This is not a terrible matchup for Lum.
Yeah, I think it's closer to 5-5 than it is to 6-4. Because right. You do have to remember that Lum, in fact, can... It is possible for him to ace dodge.
That's right.
Even that's right. though that's not going to be like that common, it is a thing that can happen.
Yeah, it is an option he can actually play when he needs to.
Yeah.
And I think the other thing that's distorting that matchup percentage, basically all of the matchup percentages, is who plays Midori in tournaments. It's Leontes, confirmed crazy yeah. person. Clan Natioi, who's yeah. just a beast. And Jister played a bit of Midori as well, and is a very well-established grappler player. So, pretty sick. Pretty sick group. So, I mean, I could understand if maybe Midori's matchups are not as shining and amazing as the historical results may say, just because you basically have three Michael Jordans playing that character.
That is very true.
But, yeah.
It's hard to get bad results when we're looking at these three players.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. It's like looking at Zane and trying to get around the skewed results that Raziak puts up there.
Thank you, Raz.
Mm-hmm.
Leontes just blocked, I think, 3 turns in a row. I'm pretty sure.
Yep.
Oh, no, only 2 turns in a row. I'm wrong.
He, big proponent of heavy blocking, and notice he's playing this match much more standard. So typically the way that Midori and all of the grapplers actually play is in the very early game, what they want to do is be throwing and blocking, because those two moves, their throws are dominant in basically everything except a grappler mirror, and their blocks are the only thing that they need to... Yeah, yes, exactly. with exceptions. but essentially, those two moves are the only things they need to beat and defend everything that anything could be played against them. The blocks will defend against all attacks, and the throws will beat everything that is a throw, or basically anything that isn't an attack. So,
yes.
Yeah. And then they build up a huge hand and then smother their opponents with...
And the other thing is they often win block trades as well.
Yeah. Yeah. All of the grapplers.
Maybe not versus Lum, but...
Yeah, that's true. One of the best... one of the most card-hungry characters in the game, so... Ooh. Yeah, that's not a flip you want. I mean, it is going to put him up to...
A lot of Lum players I've heard say that Ace Flip is actually the best because you just get such card advantage from it.
I guess that's true. And you can recur the aces, so it's not like it's an option that's gone.
Yeah.
Okay, nice play there by enomus. Lantis opened that this dragon form turn by going for Final Dragon Buster. I would think... Again, he's a human valuation trap, but I would think that if you have the K in hand, you probably play the K first. So blocking probably pretty safe against the rest of the cards in his hand, unless Leontes wants to end Dragon Form early and throw.
Yes.
Has now picked up one more of those aces, so potentially has...
Another FDB, yeah. Maybe. Which, it's probably pretty fair to say that he most likely had 3 aces in hand when he was going for the FDB, because otherwise it's not really that significant damage.
Exactly. Yeah, you're only doing 3 more damage than his...
King throw.
Than his king throw, exactly. Nice. Undercuts a J.
Good work. Not sure what the J was aiming for.
I think it was really just... Hard. Yeah, I think it was probably either to... So Leontes, in the matches that I've seen, does often cut, voluntarily ends his dragon form. usually with a throw, with a normal throw, but also with a normal attack, because the that's one of the nice places. Oh God! Okay, good. Was the Joker, so the game will continue.
Oh.
Yeah, still has nine cards in hand, so that's not as brutal as it could be. But
he had three aces in hand and one. So he actually probably had four aces in hand and was going for when he played it raw.
For literal final Dragonbuster. The most final Dragonbuster.
He was planning on it.
Oh there you go. Out. There's that interaction you were talking about.
That nerf to Midori in several of his matchups because the Quinn's matchup was just so brutal. Mm-hmm. So they had to change it. But makes these two slightly worse.
Yeah.
The Gray and the Lum.
That makes sense.
Well, it apparently made De Gray like a lot worse, but it made Lum slightly worse.
Yeah, at least his ace doesn't recur.
Yeah.
thank heavens for small for tender small mercies.
That would be rather brutal.
Yeah. Nice. So Joker of his own. That is now one Joker played for both of these players. Oh no, two Jokers played by Leontes. So all of the damage is now real.
Okay. So Leontes is gonna have to play super careful because if he gets hit by like a high normal or something, he's just gonna die.
Yeah.
Or like even I think it is Great Pandemonium lethal now? I think it is. 45.
Yeah. Would be
I think a fully pumped Pandemonium.
Exactsies. Yep. And that's off of a 0.8 speed attack.
So it's gonna beat everything except Dragon Queen.
Mm-hmm. Now he does still have one of those aces in his discard pile. I guess the one that was flipped earlier.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, Leontes is playing around. I'm wondering what he has in his hand. I guess it's got to be K's?
Could be just like a bunch of normals. You never know.
But would you be dodging? Would you be dodging?
Oh, actually, that's true. That's true.
Yeah.
But he's playing Dragon.
No, he's out. He's out.
Yeah, exactly. So you can't dodge into the good king anyway.
No, that's true. You still deal 12 damage. Yeah, okay. So that's the other thing I was going to say. The just getting a normal throw and knockdown is actually not too bad for Leontes here because it removes the potential for ace dodge from enomus.
Yeah, that's true. Normally, like, knockdown doesn't mean much to Midori because he just goes through dodges, but yeah, in this matchup specifically, you got to be just wary of those aces.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, Lum getting some free damage here. He's only been able to do, like, 14. Yeah, he's probably not going to hit there again.
Two jackpots, though, that's a bit... Well, I mean, he's already used all his aces, I suppose.
Yeah.
Maybe not such a bad thing.
Was it the first match where he did jackpot off of...
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, how could it be this one where you just flipped him off the top of his deck?
True. True facts. Oh, my God, that's a lot of dodges gone. We are down to 3 dodges...
Oh boy.
In Leontes' deck.
Very soon, he's probably just going to start spamming jacks, and
Leontes
is not going to be able to do much to stop it.
Yeah. Now, that is going to have the side effect of actually finding those dodges way faster, but Leontes has to deal damage before deck out, and it's getting very close. We've got 9 cards left in the deck for an enomus, and 17 for Leontes.
Yeah. Okay.
Goes into dragon form. I think enomus just spam attacks here because basically the only dragon moves Leontes still has access to are his kings. So you basically play J and win.
I think he still has one queen hanging around his deck.
Mm-hmm. It could have been in, I guess it's Yomi layer 2 where you know that, so enomus knows that Leontes only has kings. However, he has a lot of strong attacks, so if he attacks into him and Leontes blocks, he can recur those cards and actually get something scary going, but... yeah, Leontes admitting that... acknowledging that this is not going as well as he would have hoped. But he basically has to deal 30 damage in the next... turn or two before Lum draws his last couple cards.
Yeah. especially with Blackjack speeding up the timer.
Yeah.
That's really rough for Midori.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
And, unfortunately, because Animus can... I'm wondering if that's the setup for the next Poker Flourish.
It might be. Does he have... How many tens has he played? Three?
Yeah.
One, two, three. Yeah, he's played three tens. Yeah.
Still has three aces in the discard, so I guess...
Okay, it isn't the setup yet. I think he's actually just trying to time out.
Yeah. Because, and considering
at this
that,
point, it's going to be very...
Considering Leontes has not been willing to put out a throw recently. Oh, powering up the Jays, too. So I think he's going to gamble it all on a final Dragon Buster here.
Whether it's dodged or...
Yeah. He has the potential to dodge into it. He's got one dodge left in his deck. It's basically a 1 in 3 chance that he's got it in his hand.
Yep. I think there's almost no way he can bust this.
Yeah. We could do a quick card count, but I think that probably he can deal 14 damage.
It seems pretty likely to me.
Also, every card he flips... Yeah, that's it. And every card he flips moves the timer up even faster, so...
Yeah.
Twice as sick. Well played. Beautiful play by Animus.
I actually once saw a Blackjack play where they didn't even play to do damage because they already have more life, so they just flipped over three cards.
And oh, down. Wow.
I was like, wow, that's a rude play.
Yeah, that's really gross. That has to go on the most disrespectful move list.
Yeah, they really should. It's like not even taking the damage, just decking out.
Yeah. I don't even need to kill you with damage.
Well, I think they flipped over three and then drew the next one at draw step or something like that. And it was just like... Yeah.
Brutal.
It's a pretty rude play.
Yeah. Okay, so big swingy games for both of these players. Game one, basically, Leontes finished with about 50 health, and Enomus finished game two with 40. I think this is such an awesome series. I'm so glad we're getting to see this series, and it's like a nice back-and-forth game as well. I'm glad that the math was wrong, basically, is what I'm saying. Yeah, Enomus definitely showing that he's got a sick panda that is doing some work here.
I'm a little bit sad that we didn't get to see the zombie, but this is still pretty cool.
Yeah, like, probably
it's
better
hard
for
to get mad about this.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, oh, this hype game in front of me. Flip
wow.
table.
Diff
puff, piff puff puff.
How rude that you're not making it even hyper.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, fart noises everywhere.
When you're a yummy snob.
Yes, exactly. Please, I only want the finest yummies. Nice. Getting some throws. So I guess... I'm wondering if this is showing a tendency for Leontes to be... uncomfortable to throw in the late game unless it's with K. Essentially uncomfortable to normal throw in the late game, because we didn't see it in the first game. He ended that essentially he played some throws in the early game, although he was going ham with dragon attacks. Yeah. And he seems to have gone back to that strategy. He must have had a loaded hand. This is like the third queen he's playing. Oh, second queen, okay, but still. But yeah, and in the second game, I guess, I mean, given that Lum had either Great Pandemonium or Blackjack on deck, it makes sense. But it's something I want to keep an eye out, see if that is kind of a tendency in his play, that he removes that as an option late game when he may not.
Still blocking. Yep. Even though he's being aggressive, he's got to keep his blocks up.
Yep.
So now they're both at 11 cards, although... Oh, flips a jack. Okay.
It's actually
so 11 card heads.
Yeah, that's...
Nice card even.
I think you're happy to take the one turn slowdown. It's... Lum still has to think about throwing you on these turns. Okay, not for that reason, but because you can just play a 6 attack, because your 6 attack's not going to beat anything anyway, except greedy throws, and then stomp those in for 6 into AA or 6, 7, 8.
The brutal Midori straights.
Mm-hmm. As brutal as they are rare. Okay, so we have confirmed aces on deck. Leontes has shown us he's willing to play both sides of this thing. Okay, confirms a jack.
That's good. It's always nice to know those jacks.
Yeah. Multi-jackpot.
Confirm another jack?
Oh, queen. Okay.
Queen. All right. That's actually important, though.
Yeah, that's true.
That is his third queen. I once had someone jackpot me twice in a row. They just got the same card twice. That's some real information about my hand there. Yep.
Nice. Oh, okay. Very nice.
Good, good.
Only is going to combo into the jack. Into the jack. Oh, brutal damage.
That's... may not even need an FDB.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, yeah, we're just doing 30 damage or whatever.
Turns out, Midori has a raging demon. It's just spread over two of his face cards. Okay.
Dodges.
That is very much in favor of Midori. That is absolutely a trade you will take. Another jackpot. Okay.
Okay, we're going to hit those aces eventually.
No, no, not today! Apparently, Vendetta's variance has followed Enomus to this Lum matchup. Ooh! Nice. Ooh. Doesn't even care about the final Dragon Buster. Beautiful play. I guess he read the fact that, you know, if you're going to play something to undercut stuff, why wouldn't you lead with the queen? Because it's going to beat my queen anyway. So if you're not leading that, probably means you don't have it. And this is much safer than it ordinarily would be. Mm. Oh, and has the dragon form. Oh, good lord.
Okay, so now if he plays a queen, Enomus only has his queen or ace or gold burst answer.
Yeah. I probably dodge as Leontes here just because of those options. Oh, okay, no, you're just a crazy person. You are just a crazy person. That was a beautiful trap, too, because, like you said, ace dodge is the only thing that beats queen, therefore I will just normal throw you, because I'm pretty sure, like, oh, God, that's gross. Yeah, Enomus responding with the okay. Time to switch the music. Yeah, good call. Assassinate him. Shoutouts to Riker.
Oh, man.
Rip.
Never heard he's...
All is lost. Ooh. Riker, please. Riker, please.
Riker's ready.
Riker going in here. Doing more damage than Midori is. Wow. Leontes landing two throws. Gross.
He's just going in. He's
gross
just,
start.
Just like, right, I've downloaded you. Have some throws.
Yes, have some throws. And it's not even that... I don't think Enomus has been playing especially block or throw happy in the early game recently. This is just a... I think you're going to... Maybe it was... Oh, you know what it was? It was the music counterpick. He switched up his music, so he knew he was going to start playing... See, no, he should have played the throw side there. That's a rookie mistake right there. Always throw with the nine. I think I told you this before we started this. Don't check the tapes. Nobody check the tapes.
That's okay. I believe you. Yeah.
So, yeah, nice life advantage, even on cards, both these players. Ooh. Oh, gets the undercut.
That's going to swing some things nicely in the favor of Leontes.
Yeah, demoralizing.
Into the jack.
Yeah.
Nice.
And loses a card for his trouble, too.
Yeah. That's harsh for poor Panda.
I think, has Leontes respected any of the blue bursts so far? I don't think he has.
So I think he just goes in. Yeah. Well, the one thing I noticed about him is he doesn't seem to respect them much. He just goes in.
Yeah.
And it's like, I think that might be just like maybe kind of a Midori thing that you just have to do that. I'm not sure.
I don't. Oh, jeez.
It confirms the wrath of Earth.
Whoosh. Yeah, Razia gets it.
Alright!
Yeah, Jesus Christ!
He's almost working on a perfect here!
Christ almighty! Is this
GG? Is that it?
Does he even face down? Like, I don't think he's got the Joker at this point. That better be a joke. Okay, all right.
Oh, okay. Wow. Okay, he's got the Joker.
Oh, good lord. That is not how you want to end things. That's
Leontes has two cards in hand, though.
Yeah, that's a very good point.
Sorry. A moment of silence for Leontes' hand.
Apparently it's not going to matter, because unless he's got the second Joker in hand, this is GG.
Wow. Nine,
good lord. Perfecto! I would cover my child's eyes if I had a child and they were watching this. Jesus.
That was awful.
God, that is brutal. That is not what you want. So Leontes is now up 3-1, and he won the third match off of a perfect. That is pretty much the definition of guard break. I was hoping that Enomus would take like 30 seconds or something, just like, I don't know, go down by the pier, watch the sunset for a little bit, like.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if he can turn it around. Maybe he's Ricky Ortiz. He gets activated by Fury. Okay.
Like, when I was fighting Leontes, I was going on full tilt, and I was just like,
yeah,
gotta
yeah,
change music.
Well, it's Midori. Like, you can't... It doesn't feel fair. Like, if even the players think he's low tier or low mid tier, you're like, then why am I losing to him?
They're actually just yomiing us all, and he's actually,
yeah, exactly,
like, top tier. And they're just spreading the word that he's low tier to tilt everyone.
Yeah, exactly.
This is the longest conspiracy. Clan Nashoy, Leontes.
Early dodge. Ace, ace.
Wow.
Oh
wow.
Yeah, let her rip, why not?
Alright.
play the merry play. Nobody's expecting early dodge from Midori, right? He's gonna save those for his dragon turns so he can
shoutouts to Redless.
Yeah, exactly. Very valuable, if very difficult to understand concept at first. It's like, what are
I you? I understood it straight away. Like, everyone was complaining. Like, is this something he says?
Okay, well, you know, I'm not. You know, I'm from Canada, eh? They say I'm a little slow.
Yeah, right. Well, maybe it helps that me and Redless have played together quite a lot, so we think very similarly.
Fair enough. Leontes reloading.
But we don't talk about those matches anymore.
One in particular. Hashtag, you know the hashtag.
Can't play guitar.
Hashtag, you know the hashtag.
Yes. He changed the hashtag on this team.
Okay, here we go.
So bad.
Evening it up. Let's go.
Nice. Get those queens on there.
Yeah.
Now don't flip a queen, all right?
Yeah, I know.
Don't do it. Enomus?
Oh.
Yes.
Okay,
correct.
Good. Thank you. rookie mistake is flipping those queens early. You really don't want that.
You should know the odds, man.
You should know the odds.
You have to pass on roll the dice.
Never tell him the odds. Okay, Leontes playing his throw game with a two match lead. I mean, you can't let your guard down. You can't get lax. Especially, like, not just speaking against Enomus, like, definitely not against Enomus. He will just devour you. But any of the players in the playoffs, I mean, even in the Swiss tournament section, the tournament here is just absolutely stacked. Huge shout outs to CKR for running the, woo! I would call it the premier Yomi event. Just amazing stuff.
Oh
yeah. Okay.
Just what? Get my pom-poms?
Yeah, that's right. Pew, 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 pew.
Could we have a cheerleading squad that uses air horns, please? Yeah.
Or vuvuzelas, however you pronounce that. Uh-oh. Okay, now is this a real song switch, or is this a Yomi? Is this a musical valuation trap?
I can't click the link because I'm on... I can't do it. Hold on, I have to type it in because it's. I'm using the
Ooh, big K throw. We got a.
Oh, it's the Apollo Justice Corner music.
Ah, so we have essentially a 35 health lead. Someone who's better at faster at maths than I am will confirm. It's definitely not 35 because they're both even numbers.
Yeah,
but it's 35-ish. You know. Oh no! Oh 36. No!
Oh wow!
Oh no!
Stupid!
Oh god! Joker one time does not follow it up. Okay. I think he probably just didn't have the other aces.
Yeah.
Okay. He didn't have the fourth ace. God, that's so scary. That is the worst feeling. Jesus. Like it's bad enough that you got hit with the with the zero speed throw, but to get your ace dodge eaten by it is so brutal.
Om nom 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 nom, ace dodges.
Yeah. Throwing the opponent. There's a reason that...
So, 6-4 matchup, right?
apparently, we were... The math was more correct than we thought. I don't think... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know anything, okay? I don't know anything anymore.
We've only been in call for, like, just an hour. It's like... Goodness.
Yeah. Fast matches. I mean, Leontes plays quick. Like, he just makes those selections. And I don't think Enomus is he doesn't go into the think tank very often. I don't think we've seen the timer move off of full for either of these players. Man, talk about bad luck for this for those jackpots. I don't think a single one of those has hit.
Not one. Oh goodness, what is this? Steam, why did you do this?
Why you do? Okay.
Oh!
Pow, right in the snout.
Nice.
Gets the queen off. 16 damage.
Well, okay, now don't flip a queen. You got this enormous.
Oh, just as bad. Just as bad. I can't even imagine what Lum's hand looks like right now. Nice! Oh, very okay. Good stuff.
Still trying to king throw.
Excellent. Excellent. Leontes has not bluffed basically a single time, so good on Enomus to respect that.
Would you take the life there, or would you draw a card?
Yeah, I think... No, with 12 cards in hand, I definitely take the life.
Okay.
Granted, it's both sides of the ace are still absolutely lethal. But if you got a queen, that's a very nice play, because we just saw two of those get flipped, so... Low odds. Very nicely beaten out here.
Is enormous gonna bring it back?
I want this series to go to an ace match. My body is ready.
I don't want it to end on a 4-1. Like, I feel like the finals... I don't want it to end on a 4-1.
Mm-hmm.
It's just...
I agree. 100%. Not that these games haven't been ridiculous already, but yeah, no, we want more of them. We are greedy monsters.
Can we go to game 7?
Oh, look at that 6-4 dragon move.
Man, I'm really confident in this dragon.
Yeah. Yeah.
Leontes, check yourself before you rip this
off. Please. expensive buyback there. Mm. Although you definitely need it.
Flipping it.
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
Sick! Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom. Thank you.
No problem. Thank you for the reminder. 12? Do you hit this? I think you hit this.
Would you hit this though? How many face cards has he dropped? Okay.
Well, we know three. Yeah, there were a ton of them. It was like 8 of them in the grave, and the other 10s are in your hand, so.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually. And if he hit the 9, it would have been like. Oh,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. Infinity air horns. Oh, that was sick. And just like that, tied life totals.
Yeah, this game is suddenly 12 card hand for Enomus, 4 card hand
for Leontes. Yeah, and I believe still. Oh no, he played those aces. Okay, that is very good. That's actually good for Lum. If he gets the other 10 off, does he have the aces? He does have aces.
I'd take a full house here, to be honest.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah, that's true. Take a full house. Okay.
Because it's just, like, safer, because he has so many tents. And then you can take another full house. Oh, he could have. He could have taken another full house there.
To get him down to 7? I guess queen-queen is lethal, so... Although,
he could have put him down to 7 life, which is pretty... Like, I don't know why he didn't take the second full house. You could have taken 2 full houses and then blackjacked after that, or even full house again with some powering up shenanigans. You got 13 cards in hand. I'm sure you can swing it. Like,
yeah.
He could have just killed him.
Unless I don't think he would have missed lethal. Unless it's nerves. I mean, this you're down. Like, you know, you're down 3-1.
Do you know how to do the full house thing?
Sorry.
Do you know how to do like the full house tricks? You can do 3 full houses in a row if you do it correctly.
Oh. Oh, yeah, that's sick.
Because he had 2 aces in the discard. Sorry, no, he had 1 ace in the discard. So if you play the 10, use the 10 as part of the full house, reveal 2 tens from your hand and 1 ace. Okay, that's a full house. Discard the 10. Now you've got an ace and 10 in the discard. You play another 10, reveal a 10 and an ace from your hand, full house, 2 tens. If you have 3 aces in hand, or sorry, 2 aces in hand, you reveal another 10 and 2 aces, and you've got a third full house.
Huh. That's pretty sick. Although I think we're just gonna see the standard murder.
But like
Gurgur.
Because I think he had 3 aces in hand. Oh no, sorry, he only needed 2 aces in hand. 1 in the discard, 2 in hand, and I believe he could have full housed. Anyway, it doesn't matter. He killed him.
Yeah, sick though. Like brought it back.
Yeah, that was
crazy. GG, well played, Enomus, you scary bastard.
Do not count this man out.
Yeah, no. Oh, had the FDB.
Wow.
Bamboo boys. All right. See if Leontes is rattled. It can be tough when you're... when you had the winning option in game in hand and you take the loss, especially when you had a runaway game, you know, like he was on top, he was basically smothering Enomus that whole game.
Yeah.
And then 6 combats and it was all over.
Too many times when I'm holding like TPOS and I don't play it, I'm just like...
Yeah. Sometimes you have to play the move that is going to make you feel less shitty when it when you lose with it.
Not just doesn't connect.
Yeah. It's sometimes it's about managing your sodium intake. Salt is bad for you, kids. Ask your doctor. So even life, low hand for both of these players, so lots of blocking potential. It's basically up to Leontes how hard he wants to push the throw button, and Enomus how hard he thinks Leontes will push the throw button.
Where's my fight stick? Hold on.
Yes! Yeah, what's the sound of one man holding down back?
I actually legitimately have...
There's the ninth throw!
Tello is here.
The ninest of throws.
Goodness me.
Hot damn nine, yeah. God, we've said it earlier in the broadcast. Leontes is a crazy person. He's literally...
the craziest.
Yeah. And
he's just king throw. He's like, what are noble throws for, man? I got kinged. Like,
And the nice thing, too, there, I think that was definitely... I mean, there's no reason to play the nine throw if it's not a valuation trap. Because he played the nine throw, Enomus goes, you don't have any good throws, maybe you're gonna nine throw me again, I'll play the eight throw, and you see him push the throw button again, going back to those good buttons, the four and the king, try to get that damage.
I think it was like, if you're nine throwing me, you're probably out of options and you're gonna block, and...
Exactly, yeah. It works both ways. See, we know about Midori. Come on. Easy character.
Midori players,
easy
right?
Character.
Have you seen my, like, win-loss with Midori? I have, like, 0 losses.
That's sick. Midori champion. You should write a guide.
I should. How to win? How to not lose as Midori?
Yes. The only winning game. The only winning move is not to play the game.
Oh
man, this is what, like, 7 throws in a row.
I don't know.
It's gotta work.
He blocked in between. He blocked the queen.
Takes his pedal off the gas just for a moment. Just straightens out the car and goes right back in. Nice.
Gosh. Oh goodness.
Yeah.
And Enomus is gonna have to work hard to take this one back.
Okay, now he's actually thinking about it.
He might be respecting a blue burst.
This is, so it's gotta be, yeah, okay.
Pays off
for him. And yeah, that's why he was thinking so hard. He goes down to 3 cards and he still has to close it out with 15. I wonder if he doesn't have any throws left. He may only have like 9 and 10 throws. Or, yep, there you go. So very expensive throws to throw with right now. Which is kind of the easy, quote-unquote, way that Midori can deal 16 damage, essentially.
Yeah, yeah. I flipped a queen, though. He can't be happy about that.
No.
So, 2 queens in the discard for Enomus, but we know he still has 1 in hand.
Nice.
Ah, gets a 3. I've been waiting to see more of these normal attacks coming out from Enomus, because he's been playing a lot of face cards, but it's actually not that terrible to just play high normals,
mm-hmm.
because unless Leontes is actually going to threaten his normals, you can just play 5s as Llama and just catch throws with it, and just go into straights.
Yep. Okay, here we go. So Enomus has got to have just the strangest hand, because he played that 3 and did not follow up at all. So he's got to have just like no, I don't believe he did. I think it was just spaghetti normals.
You're right. Wow, bend hands.
Yeah, exactly.
Bended hands following you.
The disease is inside of him now, apparently.
Oh dear. Becoming a zombie.
Nice. So 12 card Lum versus 4 card Midori.
This cannot be good.
No.
At all.
The unfortunate thing is Leontes definitely has the 8, so any throw is going to be lethal, yeah. Enomus has played 1 Joker. He's got about a 50-50 shot. 1 in 3 shot of having the other Joker in his hand. Leontes has played no Jokers. So we still have potential for blue burst. I think at this point I would be too scared as Midori to gold burst. Just because there are aces on deck. That's kind of a very, very efficient way that, you don't want to give Lum Blackjack for free, basically.
Yeah, yeah, very true. Okay.
Yeah, that makes
sense. Scouting his hand, I guess.
That makes sense. There's only 1 ace in the discard for Leontes, and you would hope. Okay, nice.
There comes the queen.
16 damage? 16 damage one time?
That's his last queen.
Oh, okay, okay.
Alright, let's hope he gets it back, hey?
Okay, yeah, good.
Okay, he gets it back.
Let's see. No queens played for Leontes yet, so that queen is a very important button.
Going over some blackjack here.
Mm-hmm.
By the looks of things.
Even up the life total if he gets a nice...
Is that an undo? No? Okay, he is committing to it. All right. Strange. Okay. He took that out of his deck. Okay. He just seems to be having a bit of a dilemma.
Okay, so sort probably going to deal now. Around 14 damage here.
Roughly.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably, yeah, you take that.
Wow, exactly 14. Goodness, Juicer.
Well, you know, I mean, I'm pretty good at this game.
Yeah.
No, I think 13.5 is the average, like, blackjack.
13, exactly, okay. Which is just slightly more efficient than Great Pandemonium.
Yeah. So basically even life totals. Lum can deal a fair amount of damage off of Jack into some normals. Nice! Ooh, big win.
That's big.
Very big win.
That's important.
So now...
Still didn't land a jackpot on those aces, though.
Well, that would have been... That would have been pretty sick. That would have been a huge momentum swing into potentially game into the ace match. Or, sorry, the finals match.
But Enomus could certainly take this one. He's got these blackjacks set up.
Yeah.
He's ready to go. Like, this is not over in the slightest.
No.
And that excites me.
Oh, yeah. Okay, just went for the full house.
Okay, that's fair. He probably is holding a couple of tens in hand, I'd imagine.
Mm-hmm. He's played two of them. Oh, there we see it. Scoops the queen with his own queen. Does he get the queen back? That would be gravy. Oh, nice.
Ooh, goodness.
At this point, so now dodge. So if Midori dodges into K reveal and spins. Oh, yeah, if he blackjacks.
Oh.
The checkmates. Nice. The checkmates still has to. Oh! Holy crap. Oh god, that is not what you want. That is not what you want.
So sad.
True panda.
Interactivity. Nine cards. Oh, jeez.
Oh, God.
That is so saddening.
That is brutal.
Wow.
That is brutal. Well, I mean, if you don't have the Joker in your hand, you've got to think that it's an option. He only had eight cards in hand, so it's not inconceivable that that would happen. But that is brutal. That is absolutely brutal. It's not over. You can still get out of this, but... Oh! Into K, and that was the other Joker, wasn't it? Yeah, third Joker shows up.
But he doesn't have lethal.
Does he still have the queen? This is incredibly... Okay, he still has the queen, so he can defend against Dragon Queen.
I think right now, Enomus just has to play that queen out. Like,
how many dodges does Leontes have? The only problem is he has to play the queen, or he has to throw the dodge that Leontes is going to play.
We've only seen four dodges from Leontes, so Leontes still has... a number of dodges left.
With only five cards in hand, it is... Oh god, that's such an awful, awful feeling to have to try to figure this out. He's in dragon mode, so he can even block out of this.
Insane.
Oh!
Oh god.
Wow!
That's it! He takes the match!
Yeah, that's it. There's no way. Unless he does not have follow-up, that is game over.
He absolutely has follow-up.
Sick. Sick. Beautiful, beautiful set. That is...
Wow.
GG. GG.
What? He's waiting. Okay, there's the jack.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Wow.
Sick game. That Joker was crazy. I'm sad that we didn't get to see more matches, but
yeah.
That was some of the sickest Yomi I have seen ever.
I'm so happy that it was these two guys that made it to finals.
Yeah. Fantastic story. I can't wait to see what both of these players do in season 3. Season 3 signups are currently live at fantasystrike.com. I'll put the link in the description of the video below. So if you have an interest in playing in the game, I basically joined season 2 when I had something like 10 rook matches. Well, not 10. Okay, like 30 or 40 rook matches under my belt. So it's not inconceivable for a newcomer to do fairly well. I went about even.
And Juicy did quite well from what I saw from his records.
So. Yeah, went just under 50%, which is quite happy for me.
That's nice.
So thank you very much, Bomber, for joining me on the cast. Absolute pleasure to have you on the microphone with me, and I'll try to invite you back if we get another hype match or tournament finals. I'll tap you in.
Man, look, International Yomi League 3, I might start recording my matches and we'll see what happens.
Yes.
I promise more yelling.
Yes, I will absolutely put a link to Bomber's channel, so check out those matches. His match against Leontes in particular is absolutely sick in the feature film festival fight. Go check that out.
There were air horns, there was yelling, there was
salt. There was everything that Yomi's about was perfectly summarized in that match.
Plenty of fraud.
Yeah. So thanks again, everyone, for watching. Leave a comment or a like or a subscribe or whatever. But most importantly, enjoy yourself some Yomi. Thanks, everyone.